amphibians are the first dual living organisms. That means they live in water as well as on land. Amphi means both. The bions means here, the bios means they lead amphibious life. They are the first vertebrates. They are jumped to land from water. Here you can see amphibians are the first vertebrates. They jumped from water to land. Nearly 3,000 to 4,500 living species of amphibians are found all over the world. Amphibians are evolved from osteolipid fishes during Devonian period. They are highly flourished during Carboniferous period. Here, the Carboniferous period is the golden age of amphibians, in which they flourished a lot in this era. That's why they are called, the Carboniferous period is called the golden age of amphibians. They lead dual life. They live in water as well as on land. They are cold-blooded, carnivorous, mesonephric, mesolicital, oviparous animals. Cold-blooded means they they can change their temperature according to the surrounding environments. Here, the carnivorous means they feed on animal content. Mesonephric means the kidney is moderately developed. Mesolicital means they show the moderate amount of yolk. Oviparous. Here, you can see the amphibians are egg-laying animals. Some animals may be the viviparous. They are tetrapod. Here, the tetrapod means they are having two pairs of the forelimbs and two pairs of hind limbs. That's why they are called tetrapods. Here, you can see the amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals are called as tetrapods. They can hibernate during winter, but during summer, they go for aestivation. Here, hibernation means in which during severe cold and chill, they can go for winter sleep. The winter sleep, what you called as hibernation. And during this condition, the animals can use fat as their reserved feed material. Here, aestivation during summer, during drought, or during severe water scarcity, they go for aestivation or summer sleep. Summer sleep also, they can use reserved food material in the form of fat. Body is divisible into head, neck, trunk, and tail. Some cases, tail and neck is absent in some forms. Limbs are pentadactyl in nature, supported by girdles. True claws are absent. Skin is smooth, moist, and glandular. Pigmented or poisonous glands may be present. Skin is smooth and it is watery in nature. It acts as a respiratory organ in the case of amphibians, and it shows a parotid glands in the case of toad. This is one of the poisonous glands. Scales are absent. Skull is dicondylic. That means they show two occipital condyles. Vertebrae are posceles or opisthoceles or amphiceles in nature. True sternum developed first time in the case of amphibians. Here, the mouth is large and studded with teeth. The teeth are homodont, polypodont, acrodont, or pleurodont. Here, homodont means the teeth are similar in shape. That means they are similar in shape and size Such a condition, what you called as homodont, polypoiodont means in their lifetime, several times the teeth are formed. Such a condition we call as polypoiodont. Acrodont means they are present on the floor of the jawbone. That's why they are called acrodont. Fluorodont means they are not completely embedded in the jaw, it is present on the side of the jaw, that such condition we called as fluorodont. The elementary canal starts with mouth and ends with cloaca. Cloaca is the last part of the digestive system. Cloaca, it acts as a bridge in between the reproductive system as well as digestive system and excretory system. The digestive system as well as the reproductive system is associated with cloaca. Larynx or voice box appeared in amphibians. Vocal cords are present in anurans like frogs. The respiration is by lungs, skin or gills. Buccal cavity also acts as a respiratory organ. Here, tadpole respire through gills and the adult frog respire through skin or through buccal cavity or through the lungs. Heart is three-chambered with two auricles and two ventricles. This heart is shows incomplete double respiration. That means here the left auricle receives the blood, pure blood, and impure blood is received by the from body parts is received by the right auricle, and the ventricle where it mixes. And this mixed blood goes to various parts of the body. That's why here there is no complete separation of blood. Such a deoxygenated blood goes into various parts of the body. That's why it is called as the incomplete double respiration. The accessory organs of the heart, the sinus venosus as well as truncus arteriosus are also present. Three aortic arches like carotid arch, which goes into the brain, the systemic arch, which goes into the various parts of the body, as well as the pulmonary arch goes into the lung. That's why three aortic arches are present in the case of the amphibians. Hepatic portal system as well as renal portal system are well developed. The RBC are biconvex, oval and nucleated. 10 pairs of cranial nerves are seen in the case of amphibians, but in the case of the snakes, ophidians, here the brain also shows 10 pairs of cranial nerves. Kidneys are mesonephric but is moderately developed, but larval stage shows pronephric kidneys. Excretory material is urea. That's why these animals are called ureotelic. Urinary bladder is present. Generally, the tadpole excretes ammonia, whereas the adult frog excretes urea. Such a type of excretion, what you call as ureotelic. If it excretes urea, we call as ureotelic. If it excretes ammonia, we call as ammonotelic. If they excrete uric acid, we call as uricotelic animals. Copulatory organs are absent in the case of males. Amphibians are oviparous. Oviparous means they are egg laying. Some are viviparous. Eggs are mesolicital. Mesolicital means they show moderate amount of yolk. And anamniotes means here the fishes and amphibians are called anamniotes. In their life history, the fetal membranes are not formed. Here you can see the amnion, chorion, allantois and yolk sac are completely absent. That's why they are called anamniotes or non-amniotes. Development is indirect and it shows tadpole larva. Here development is generally two types. If the development includes larval form, such a development, what you called as indirect development. If the development does not include any larval form, such a development we call as direct development. Here the tadpole larva as well as the axolotl larva is seen in salamander. Cleavage is holoblastic and incomplete. This is the gist about the amphibians.